Greetings from the great state of North Dakota. The last 15 months have been as interesting and challenging as any period in our state's 132-year history. From the start, we approached the pandemic with the goal of saving lives and livelihoods. We recognized that physical and economic health are both essential to the well-being of our citizens. Our team members worked tirelessly to keep testing rates among the highest in the U.S. and use a common sense approach to protect our most vulnerable and minimize economic harm of mitigation protocols and ensure that safe and effective vaccines were available as quickly as possible to any citizen who wanted a shot. Our school districts were successful at keeping our children learning in school, and our communities kept businesses open safely. We believed in and encouraged personal responsibility at all times, and North Dakotans responded with great care for their families, their neighbors, and their communities. Given the strength of our economy and our very robust job market is even stronger now than pre-pandemic, we were among the first to end the federal supplement unemployment payments, bringing our North Dakota unemployment programs back to pre-pandemic levels, recognizing that returning workers safely to the workforce is the best recovery plan. Working together, North Dakota has emerged stronger than ever as our administration seeks to empower people, improve lives, and inspire success. We recently helped ADM announce a $350 million soybean crushing plant in eastern North Dakota, the first of its kind in our state, and this will be a great boon for value added for all of our great soybean producers. This plant will send soybean oil to the western side of our state to be refined into renewable green diesel for exports to such markets as California. A month ago, Mitsubishi Power and Bakken Energy announced a strategic partnership to establish a world-class clean hydrogen hub in North Dakota. This exciting partnership will create the largest producer of blue hydrogen in North America, taking advantage of our abundant natural gas supplies and producing clean fuels that'll be great for our environment. That announcement came just a few weeks after we issued the aspirational challenge to our entire state to become carbon neutral by the year 2030. We won't achieve this goal with federal mandates or more regulation or more red tape. We will only accomplish it with an approach that prioritizes innovation from the private sector over regulation. The geologic jackpot in North Dakota is an asset for our entire country, with underground storage and sequestration capacity for 250 billion tons of CO2. Yes, 250 billion tons. That's enough space to store almost 50 years worth of the entire United States annual energy-related carbon output, or over 4,000 years worth of our own state's carbon output. We've also just completed and launched a first of its kind in the nation, $870 million private-public partnership as one component of a local plus two states plus the federal government plus Army Corps of Engineers to create a $2 billion plus flood protection project, which serves over 80 square miles, including the entire Fargo, North Dakota and Moorhead, Minnesota metro area. This unique financing approach and the utilization of the private sector will save taxpayers over $1 billion in taxes and flood insurance premiums, as the project will be completed in 6 years versus 15 years. This is a model that our entire country should consider as we embark on upgrading our nation's infrastructure. But currently, we're focused on a more immediate challenge, one with potentially disastrous consequences, and that's extreme drought conditions, which I know many of our other states are facing as well. The period from October through April was the driest on record in North Dakota since record keeping began 127 years ago. Wildfires in 2021 have already consumed more than 100,000 acres or 156 square miles. That's more than 10 times what we had in 2020. As we work through these challenges and these amazing opportunities, we are deeply grateful for the partnership and collaboration of our fellow Western Governors Association states, and especially the fellow governors who've all been fantastic partners working together for decades, but especially working together in a deep way during these past 18 months. Western Governors Association provides an incredible forum for sharing best practices and lessons learned. It truly is invaluable, especially during times of crisis. I'm grateful for each and every Western governor that I've had a chance to meet and learn from. And I also want to say thank you to the wonderful staff at WGA. I look forward to seeing all of you in person again soon. Thank you, and have a fantastic 4th of July and a great rest of the summer.